Hello, math class. This is Mr. Jacobs. Now we're looking at taking some notes on the key concepts of midpoints, segment bisector, and then also the idea of distance and distance formula of a segment. So it says in your own words, write the meaning of each vocabulary term, midpoint and segment bisector. So here are the definitions of those vocabulary words, those terms. So let's look at the definitions and then you go back and write them in your own words. So here are the core concepts. A midpoint of a segment is a point that divides the segment into two congruent segments. Another way of saying that is, hey, when you cut a segment in half, that halfway point is the midpoint. It's the middle, right? So geometry is about writing these statements down precisely using a different language. And so one of the ways of doing this is when you see the value or the point M has a coordinate, coordinates too, by the way, X and Y. But anyway, M is a midpoint of AB. And when you write AB, you're saying that when you have this line across the top, it's not a line, it's a segment. So M is the midpoint of segment AB. By the way, lines don't have midpoints. Segments have midpoints. So since you have a midpoint, then what you also know is that the segment is divided up into two pieces. The first piece is called segment AM, right? That's segment AM. And then the second piece would be called segment MB, right? Segment MB. And those two segments are congruent. What's that mean when segments are congruent? It means they have the same lengths. They have equal lengths. And another way of saying that is that you would say the length of AM equals the length of segment NB, right? The length of segment AM equals the length of segment NB. And that's what's going on here. That's what's going on here. Now, why isn't there a bar across the top? Why don't we have a bar across the top each of these names? Well, it's because when you say AM equals MB, you are literally saying that the value of the length equals the value of the other segment length. So you can say, for instance, what you get a numerical value, let's say 6, and let's say this has length of 6, right? Then what you're saying technically is that the length of 6 equals the length of 6. Or you could also say, a step further, you could say that AM equals 6, and so does MB. Another way of saying it. So it has to equal some value when you have AM equals, right? Now, if you don't know what that value is, but you know they're congruent, then you would just write segment AM is congruent to segment MB. So I hope that makes some sense. Now, moving on. Let's get rid of this here. A segment bisector. Now, again, a segment bisector is either a point, array, a line segment, or even a plane that intersects a segment at its endpoint. A midpoint or a segment bisector bisects a segment. So how can you divide a segment in half? Well, you can do it a couple of ways. You can use just a point called a midpoint. You can use a whole line, right? You can use another segment, right? If you were just looking at, let's say, this segment here from here to here, that could divide the segment. You can use array. Here's what array looks like. It has a start point, but no end point. See that? That's array. And this is also array here. So all of those things can divide a segment in half. Now, a couple of things that I forgot to mention, though, and I may have mentioned in another video, I don't remember. But when you say that segments are congruent, right, segments are congruent, then you can use these special markings called tick marks. And so since this tick mark is between A and M, right, this segment here, what you are saying specifically is that segment has a certain length, but this other segment here has also the same length since it has the same tick mark. You're saying those are congruent segments. Alrighty? And now what we know about line CD, that's what this says, right? It says line CD is a segment bisector. Oh, what's that mean when you're a segment bisector? That means you divide the segment into what? Into two congruent pieces, right? How? Because the segment bisector intersects the segment at its midpoint. Now, what's a midpoint do? It divides the segment in half. And so CD is a segment bisector of segment AB, right? Line CD is a segment bisector of segment AB. So segment AM is congruent to segment MB. And therefore, the length of AM is equal to the length of segment MB. So I hope that makes some sense too. Now let's look at the midpoint formula. Now here, we talked about this in our exploration. And let's read what it says. It says, the coordinates of the midpoint of a segment are the averages of the x and y coordinates of the endpoints. We'll read that one more time. The coordinates of the midpoint of a segment are the averages of the x coordinates and of the y coordinates of the endpoints. So if point A and point B are the points in the coordinate plane, then the midpoint M of segment AB has these coordinates. So you sum the value of the x coordinates and divide by 2, then you sum the value of the y coordinates and divide by 2. That's how you find the coordinates of the midpoint. Let me discuss that. So that is the exact formula. Here's a picture of the situation, and it shows a method for deriving the formula. Again, it might not make a whole lot of sense to you about how to derive that formula graphically, but again, there was an exploration that we studied, and you can try to fight your way through that and see if it makes any sense. I did, and it made some sense. Let's see if you can do it. Let's see if you can try to derive this formula based on the ruler postulate and things of that sort, all right? So that's the formula you need to know for the quiz right here, the midpoint formula. Gotta know that. And then the last one is this distance formula. And we also had an exploration on that. And here it is. It says the distance formula. If point A and B are points in the coordinate plane, then the distance between A and B is AB equals the square root of x squared minus x sub 1 squared plus y sub 2 minus y sub 1 squared. That is the formula. And it's derived from the Pythagorean theorem. And again, here is a picture of that situation. And it might make some sense, but if you substitute these values here into the Pythagorean theorem, take these values here, which represent the length, and square them, right? Then it, and solve for C, then you would get this formula. Now, I want to show you something just for case in point. So if I take the square root, then I get C equals the square root of A squared plus B squared. See that? That's the value of C, the length of the hypotenuse. So how is that related to this up here? Well, all I am saying, Mary, is this, that A is this length of that leg. How do you find the length of the leg? You take the x coordinates and subtract them. Here, same thing. Your leg here, B, you take the y coordinates and subtract them. So this would be your, now I used the different colors, I should have used the right ones. But you take these coordinates here and subtract them. That would be your value of B. And then your x coordinates, you would subtract those to get the value of A, right? So this would be your A, your B, and your C. That might make some sense too. Study it, see if it makes some sense. And so those are the two formulas that you need to know for the upcoming quiz. Yes, 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 this week. So there are the notes all laid out for you. Check them out, study them. It's part of your assignment. write them down. So I hope that helps. Like I always say, study hard and learn a lot. We will see you soon. Bye-bye.